Hello, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to Algo Trading. In this short video, we are going to explore two basic portfolio investment strategies: momentum of return and momentum as difference between price and trend. And we will see how the portfolio optimization methods could help us to improve our investment results. The momentum is difference between two prices taken over a fixed interval. It is another word for speed, the distance covered over time. However, everyone is used to mean change, so it's a simple price change. The idea behind the momentum strategy is quite simple. If the price increased earlier, it will continue to do it in the future too. It's convenient to express all markets in the same notation. It makes comparison much easier. So, for the stock market, momentum can be expressed as a daily return. The term momentum is very flexible. It is common for it to refer to the difference between today's price and the corresponding moving average value. As the momentum becomes larger, prices are moving away from the moving average. And if the momentum becomes smaller, the speed of price change becomes slower too. The prices are moving toward moving average or even in the negative direction. Here is calculation for momentum of return, and here is momentum as a difference between price and trend. I have already created an alpha model which is implementing these two types of momentum, so we can simply test it with different parameters. Let's calculate our momentum over 1 year and select 10 stocks with the higher momentum. We are going to rebalance our portfolio once in a month, and all assets are going to get the equal allocation in the portfolio. Now, we can copy our configuration and set another type of momentum. Let's add our configuration to the test and backtest them on the period from 2005 until 2015. So, you may see that these both strategies have very similar volatility and drawdown, and they both outperform investment in an index. However, we must accept a little bit more risks than holding an index. How we can improve it? Well, we can try to use some of the portfolio optimization methods to see if it will help to reduce that risk to the index level. Instead of equal allocation model, we are going to use model that implements few optimization methods from the Pi Portfolio Opt package. You already must know it from my previous video about the portfolio optimization. Here I show how to change our configuration to be able to use portfolio optimization allocation model. We are going to use two well-known methods, CLA and HRP, and two more specific, efficient CVAR, conditional value at risk, and efficient CDR, conditional drawdown at risk. Please check the official documentation if you want to know more about these methods. All these methods are working not so fast, so we need to relax and wait until the backtesting is done. We may see that all methods improve our results. Our initial momentum of return strategy, which is using allocation based on conditional value at risk optimizer, reduces drawdown almost 12%. And the same strategy with conditional drawdown at risk optimizer improves our return almost in 3%. We saw that just to change allocation model, we can improve our results significantly. There are a lot of ways to improve this initial strategy, but what is more important is that the simple idea works and outperforms the market. And we can implement it with a few simple steps. So, this is all for today and see you in the next video. Bye.